A local persistent volume represents a local disk directly attached to the Kubernetes node. Kubernetes provides a powerful volume plugin that lets you use a variety of block and file storage to persist data. For example, on AWS you can use EBS volumes, on GCP you can attach persistent disk to the pod. Most of these plugins enable remote storage. These remote storage systems persist data independent of the Kubernetes node where the data originated. Usually, remote storage cannot offer the same consistent high performance compared to the directly attached disks. With a local persistent plugin, you can now consume the local storage using the same volume API. In this example, we use a remote GP2 storage class based on the EBS volumes. If you want to attach a local SSD disk to the pod instead, you just need to swap GP2 to SSD disk storage class. The local provisioner will find available persistent volume and use it for the pod. Now let's talk about host path volume. To better understand the benefits of local persistent volume plugin, let's compare it to the host path volume. Host path volumes mount a file or directory from the host node's file system into a pod. Similarly, a local persistent volume mounts a local disk or partition into a pod. The biggest difference is that Kubernetes scheduler understands which node a local persistent volume belongs to. With host path volumes, a pod reference, a host path volume may be moved by the scheduler to a different node, resulting in data loss. But with local persistent volumes, the Kubernetes scheduler ensures that the pod is always scheduled to the same node. Let me run a quick demo. I already created VPC and EKS cluster using Terraform. You can find all the code in my GitHub repository. The link is in description. We have two nodes Kubernetes cluster. Here we have Postgres database as a stateful set. It's by no means a production-ready deployment. It's just simplified version for the demo. The important part here is that we use host path volume to persist data in database across pod restarts. If the pod moves to another node, data will be lost. The path attribute is a Kubernetes node location where we want to store data from Postgres. Type is directory or create. If there is no directory, Kubernetes will create it. Then we use local disk volume and mount it to the pod. Let's get all the nodes in the cluster. In the top window, I run watch-kubectl-get-pods command. Now let's create a stateful set. Take a note of the node name where Postgres is deployed. Next, connect to the Postgres and create a new database. You can use kubectl port forward command with a pod name and specify the default Postgres port number 5432. In a new window, let's connect to it using psql. Password is secret123. Now create test hostpath database. If you list databases, you can see test hostpath here. Now let's drain the node where the Postgres is deployed. It will force the Kubernetes scheduler to move it to a different node. You can see that the pod is recreated. Let's try to connect to Postgres again and check if we have the data there. As you can see, we don't have our test hostpath database anymore, since the pod was moved to a different virtual machine. That's the biggest downside of hostpath volumes. There are still some use cases where you want to use hostpath volumes. For example, if you want to collect metrics from the nodes, you can run Prometheus node exporter and use hostpath to allow node exporter to access proc files, or CI advisor to get metrics for your containers. Even for the local persistent volume plugin, we would need to mount it as a hostpath and allow daemon set to access and discover local disks. Let's move on to the local persistent volumes. As I said before, a local persistent volume uses local disks directly attached to the Kubernetes nodes. There are a few prerequisites. First of all, we need to attach additional disks to the Kubernetes nodes. It will vary based on your setup. Do you use cloud or bare metal Kubernetes? For this demo, to keep it generic, I will attach disks to the EKS managed node group. To do that, I created launch template in Terraform and used it in my EKS node group resource under launch template block. Also for EKS, I used public subnets to be able to SSH to the nodes and added port 22 to the security group. First, we need to SSH to the nodes directly, format and mount disks. You can find all the commands in GitHub as well. It's a best practice to use UUID to mount a disk. Let's use it and create folder mount SSD disks and UUID. To persist after restarts, you also need to add this to etc fstab. Let me do exactly the same thing for the second Kubernetes node. Alright, now we need to deploy a local provisioner. It will auto-discover the mounted disks and create persistent volumes for us. Under the mount tier, you need to specify where you mounted your disks. If you have more than one disk, this provisioner will use this rule to discover all of them. You will be limited by the number of disks that the virtual machine can support. Also, specify the file system here. Then we need RBAC policies to grant access to provisioner to create persistent volumes. And a daemon set, we have to run this provisioner on each Kubernetes node. Here we use the mount path with the destination to the mounted disks. And finally, the storage class that will use this local provisioner. You have to use wait for the first consumer binding mode and give it a name such as SSD disks. For the reclaim policy, you can specify delete or retain after the pod is deleted. Let's go back to the terminal and apply the whole folder. Let's verify that we don't have any errors in the logs and the provisioner was able to discover our disks. It was able to find a new volume at the host path and create PV. Let's get all the persistent volumes in the cluster. We have two volumes created based on the attached disks. Now let's use it for our Postgres. It's straightforward, just specify storage class name equal to SSD disks. Let's apply it now. If you rerun kubectl getpv, you can see that the volume is now used by the Postgres. Let's try to drain the node and check if the Kubernetes will move this pod to a different worker. As you can see, since the node is no longer available, Kubernetes will wait till it joins back the cluster. Until then, it will be in pending state. Now, when a node has joined the cluster, the Kubernetes scheduler will place it to the same node and persist all the data in the database. If you want more videos like this, subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.